Once we have a CSV file with the data we want to access, there's a few things you might need to know about working with CSV files and your Python code, just aspects that can mess around with your data if you don't understand them correctly. So let's talk a bit about how to read and write CSV files and use that interacting with the pandas data frames that Christopher was talking about earlier. So the read CSV command is what we use to load a data frame from a CSV file. So let's say we have a nice file here which has name, city, country, and again that list of airports. What we can do is we can simply call read CSV, pass it the name of that file, put in our nice tidy little data folder that we created, and it creates the data frame for us. Now, something you might notice is that we did have a row which indicated the name, city, country, the names of our columns, and the read CSV automatically figured out that was the values for our column names. So you'll see the columns have headers of name, city, and country. You'll also notice that an index was created automatically because, as you saw, Christopher showed you, data frames have an index. That index was created automatically for the rows from our CSV file. Now, if you have any problems inside your CSV file, because you know, sometimes you don't have control over where these files come from. One of the things you have to worry about in your Python code is how are you going to handle those types of errors in different situations with your Python code. So in this case, if you take a look at the CSV file, there's an extra comma in the row for London. So we have the airport's called Heathrow, city is London, and then we have this extra two commas. So in this case, it actually sees four values instead of three for that particular row. And by default, that's actually going to crash, and it won't load any data at all into our data frame. But good news, pandas has some fantastic features you can use. For example, there's an error bad lines, and if you set that to false, that means just skip the rows of the errors and load everything you've got. So in this case, you can see I can load the data frame, and their row for Heathrow London is missing from the loaded data. Of course, this is only okay if it's all right to skip those rows. Now, what other situations do we deal with? Well, maybe the data file that you receive doesn't actually have values for the column headers. So in that case, it might get confused. So one of the things we can also do with pandas is your Python code, you can specify the header is none, in which case the read CSV will automatically create column headers. It'll just call the columns 0, 1, 2, and so on. So it'll create a column index to make up for the fact that it doesn't know what the column names are. So you need to know when you're writing Python code if that CSV file has a header row or not. This is one way to handle it. But you might have noticed when Christopher was writing that code to query a data frame, it was really convenient to have names for your columns. That's okay, we can fix that as well. So the other thing you can do is you can provide names for your columns by specifying the names parameter. So if we add a names parameter here, and we say I want to use name, city, and country as the names of the three columns, there's no column names in my file, but now you can see I successfully assigned names to each column when it created the data frame. If you have any missing values, one of the things to get used to when you're working with Python and pandas specifically is this thing called NaN, and that's the way blank values are going to appear. So if we take a look at this file, you can see the record for Schiphol Airport in the Netherlands, the city value, there's nothing specified. So in this case, when I call read CSV, you'll see that it shows the NaN as the value for the city for Schiphol. If you have manipulated your data and started working with data, sometimes you want to save your changes so that you can go back to them later. So in addition to being able to read data from a CSV file into a pandas data frame, you'll also be able to take data in a pandas data frame and write it to a CSV file. So we do that with two CSV, but what you'll see that might throw you off initially is the index values will be written to the file as well. So you can actually see, because my data frame had an index, that the file created has these index values saved as well. That's fine if you want it. If you don't want it, then all you have to do is specify index equals false, in which case it will not include the index values inside the created CSV file. Okay, let's go into some notebooks and try that out in some code.